Good morning, everybody. Good morning, Compraise family. Good morning, church. Good morning, people of God. Thank you again for joining us in our online worship celebration. Good to see you all. This is again Pastor Doms bringing you the good news from the Word of God. Indeed, God has a word for all of us today, and I'm so excited to share God's word to you. God has a word for us. This is a word that will mold us to be the kind of person God wants us to be. This is also a word that will usher us to do the will of God for our lives. So church, are you ready for the word of God? If you're ready, then let us pray together. Hallelujah. Our Father in heaven, we thank you, Lord, for this day. We worship you, we honor you, we give you praise and glory. Lord, thank you for your word today. Thank you for the word that you have prepared for us. Mold us, develop us into a kind of person that you want us to be. Lord, as we receive your word today, give us understanding. Give us wisdom and a good heart to receive your word. We pray for the Holy Spirit to come and minister to us in a very special way. In Jesus' name I pray, amen and amen. Hallelujah. Last Sunday, we started a series of study about discipleship or the processes involved in discipleship based on the command of Jesus in Matthew chapter 28, beginning with verse 18 to 20. And the Word of God says, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you, and surely I am with you always to the very end of age." We praise God for the reading of His Word. Hallelujah. So we are now studying this great commission. We are learning about the processes involved in making disciples. Okay, so last Sunday I shared to you the first two M's of discipleship. The first M is the making of a disciple. The Bible says, go and make disciples. And the second M is the marking, or the marking of a disciple. When Jesus said, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Today, I would like to share to you the third M in making disciples, and that is the molding of a disciple. Okay, the molding of a disciple. In verse 20 of Matthew chapter 28, it says there, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. Teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. So, yan po ang bahagi ng Great Commission na nais nating talakayin ngayong araw na ito. Well, we live at a time when many claim to believe that the Bible is truly the Word of God. But few live by its principles or truths, especially if these biblical principles or teachings go up against their desire or way of life. Yung bang parang minsan, parang selective na lamang po. Ano po? Pagka gusto mo yung word, okay ito. Pag ayaw mo yung word, parang pag hindi ka pa ready, parang hindi pwede ito. Okay? This is why those who truly claim as a true disciple or follower of Jesus Christ must believe and obey what the Lord Jesus Christ said to them. Amen? Remember, Jesus said, therefore, go and make disciples of all nations. And He said, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And verse 20 says, and teaching them to obey everything that I've commanded you. Hindi niya sinabi, and obey some that I have commanded you. But he said, obey everything that I have commanded you. So the third M of discipleship is the molding of a disciple. The molding of a disciple. So after the making, which is when a person believed and accepted Jesus Christ to be his or her Lord and Savior, then the marking, okay? He needs to obey and follow the Lord in water baptism. Then Jesus said, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And I call this the molding of a disciple. Amen? This is the topic today, the molding of a disciple. So the third M of discipleship is molding. Molding through the Word of God. This is a lifetime process. Meaning, you know, as a true disciple, we must believe, obey, grow, and be molded or be transformed through the Word of God. Amen? So when Jesus said, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you, meaning we need to have that passion and we need to have that desire. We need to have that obedience to follow the Lord, okay, and His Word. We need to have a hunger and desire for the Word of God to obey God's Word. That's why I said, I believe this is the longest process in discipleship, or it takes a lifetime process. The molding of a disciple through the Word of God or through the commands of Jesus Christ. Kaya nga, in this process, meron tayong tinatawag na discipleship track, which is, you know, yung tinatawag nating maturing relationship track or MRT 101, 201, 301, 401, 501. Lahat po ito ay ginagamit natin sa ating discipleship track towards the your maturity. And lahat po ito is based on the Word of God. Okay? So how can we use the Word in molding the believers or the disciples? Last Sunday, we defined disciple as a growing follower of Jesus Christ. A growing follower of Jesus Christ. So as a disciple of Jesus Christ, we need to grow. We need to grow in our love for God, in our love for our neighbors. We need to grow in our faith. We need to grow sa ating obedience sa Word of God. Remember, Romans chapter 10, verse 17 says, faith comes by hearing and hearing the Word of God. Ang pananampalataya po ay nagsisimula sa pakikinig, pag-aaral, pag-unawa, at pagbubulay-bulay sa salita ng Diyos. You know, as you keep hearing and hearing the Word of God, that's when your faith grows. That's when your faith, you know, grows and strengthens. And kaya kailangan natin ng makinig at mag-spend time with the Word of God. If you are struggling and you are facing some temptation in your Christian life today, I suggest that you go back to the Word. You go back to your devotion, to your quiet time. And if there's anything that is not pleasing in your life today, go back to the Word. Okay? Go back to the Word. So today, let's learn how the early disciples, okay, of Jesus Christ treat the Word of God. So, you know, as a disciple, let's talk about our attitude towards the Word of God or the command of Jesus Christ. So your attitude, how you receive and treat the Word of God matters. How you treat and give importance to the Word of God, that will determine your growth and success as a Christian believer. So what should be our attitude? Number one is this, to hear and accept the Word of God in our hearts. To hear and accept the Word of God in our hearts. Okay, on the parable of the poor soils or of the sower, in Matthew chapter 4, verse 20 says, others like seed, which is the word of God, sown on good soil, which represents the hearts of the people, hear the word and accept it and produce a crop 30, 60, or even 100 times of what was sown. Hallelujah. So church, the four soils in this parable represent the different ways people respond in their heart to God's word or to Christ's command. So, I pray that let us strive to be like the good soil in every area of our lives at all times, which is to hear and accept the word of God in our hearts. So, ganito dapat ang ating pag-uugali sa salita ng Diyos, ang tanggapin ng maluwag ang salita ng Diyos sa ating mga puso. Remember that there is an enemy who tries to snatch away the word of God from us. Yung minsan, papasok lang sa isang tenga natin at susunod lalabas rin sa kabilang tenga. In Matthew chapter 4, verse 9, Jesus said, "He who has ears to hear, let him hear." But let me tell you what, church, the deeper kind of hearing is listening with our hearts and mind. Okay? Because the entrance of the word brings light. It brings light to our minds, to our hearts. Sabi nga again sa Romans 10, chapter 10, verse 17, that faith comes by hearing and hearing and hearing the word of God. So if you want your faith to grow, then keep hearing and hearing the word of God. Hearing here means to make it your own and to receive it with understanding. To accept means to give room for it in our hearts. So, again, the best way to hear and receive God's word is to make our hearts a good and fertile ground of the word of God. The word of God is just like a seed that is planted in our hearts. So the seed of the word of God will grow and bear fruit up to 100 times of what was sown. So the word of God that you receive will make you fruitful. Amen? You want to be a fruitful disciple? Then receive the word of God. Number two, as a disciple, our attitude towards the word is to accept it as the word of God and not as word of men. Amen? So itong salita ng Diyos, ay tanggapin ito na tunay na salita ng Diyos para sa iyo at hindi lamang ito salita ng tao. So the right attitude towards the word is to really welcome it as a powerful word of God, as God's message for you. You see, for example, if you see me speaking today to you right now, remember the message that I preach comes from the word of God. God is only using me to preach the word, but it is actually the message of God for us. Paul said in 1 Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 13, sabi dito, "And we also thank God continually because when you receive the word of God, which you heard from us, you accepted it not as the word of men, but as it actually is, the word of God which is at work in you who believe." Amen? So dito si Paul ay nagpapasalamat sa mga taga-Tesalonica na kung saan na tinanggap nila ang kanyang pangangaral bilang salita ng Diyos at hindi po salita ng tao. Kaya kumikilos ang Diyos sa kanilang buhay. And in verse 13, sabi doon, "And the word of God is effectively working in you who believe." Okay? So, if you believe, the word of God is working effectively in you. So, we use the word of God as the basis of our message. Every time we share the word of God, it is the word of God from the Bible. Let us be word of God conscious. We must accept and stand in His word. When God said it, okay, let's believe it, then that settles it. Amen, church? Pag sinabi ni Lord, paniwalaan natin, that settles it. As you believe and accept the word of God, even as you go to sleep and relax, or even when your problems come, the word of God is working in you and through you. Kaya, as a true disciple of Jesus Christ, we must value the word of God, accept it, and believe it as from God and not from men. You know, every day, let us be consistent student of the word of God, learning, reading, receiving it with all our heart. Number three, as a disciple, our attitude towards the word is to receive it with great eagerness. Yes, to receive it with great eagerness. Yung tanggapin natin ng may kagustuhan o pananabik mula sa ating mga puso. Dapat tayo po ay laging nananabik sa salita ng Diyos. There is that enthusiastic desire or interest to make it your own. Yung hindi ka na kailangan pang pilitin pa o kalad ka rin pa para makinig ng salita ng Diyos. Hindi yung para kang palaging hinihila ng kaaway para makinig ng Diyos. But you know what? Kaya na kailangan natin magkaroon tayo ng eagerness. Magsimula sa ating mga puso. Okay? So, there are probably many, many things that attracts your attention every day pagkatapos mong magising. But you know what, church? Be determined to stay in the Word and focus on the Word of God. You know, in the Bible, the Berean believers are of noble character. In Acts chapter 17, verse 10 and 11, sabi dito, as soon as it was night, the brothers sent Paul and Silas away to Berea. Okay? On arriving there, they went to the Jewish synagogue. Now the Bereans were of noble character than the Thessalonians, for they received the message with great eagerness and examined the scriptures every day to see if what Paul said was true. Wow! Hallelujah! What a great attitude! Alam nyo, sana lahat ng mga disciples ni Jesus, lahat ng mga followers ni Jesus, lahat ng mga nagsasabing mga Christian believers, and those who believe in the Word of God, ay dapat parang maging katulad ng mga Bereans. They have the eagerness to hear the Word of God. And then, after they hear the Word of God, they check the Scripture, they double check, they study it again to see if what they heard was true. Amen? So, itong mga disciples or mga mananampalataya sa Berea ay mas bukas ang kanilang kaisipan sa pagtanggap ng salita ng Diyos. Kaya mga anak, mga young people, mga kapatid, sana tayo rin po ay magkaroon ng eagerness to go to the Word of God every day. Sila gustong-gusto nilang makinig sa mga itinuturo ni na Pablo. At araw-araw nilang sinasiliksik ang kasulatan kung totoo nga ang sinasabi ni Pablo. In verse 12, ano pong nangyari doon? Many of the Jews believed, as did also a number of prominent Greek women and many Greek men. May mga naniniwala, okay? May mga na-attract dahil sa kanilang attitude because of their eagerness to study the Word of God. Yung mga Greek men and women, okay, at mga Jew ay naniwala din at sila rin po ay naging mananampalataya. Alam nyo, mga kapatid, bilang mga Christian believers, kapag tayo po ay nagpakita ng pagiging eager natin in studying the Word of God, kapag bukas ang ating kaisipan sa salita ng Diyos, if we enjoy studying the Word of God, be it individually or as a cell group, kapag nakikita yung spirit natin about studying the Word of God, you know, more and more people will be won for the Lord. And many will believe the Word of God. Ito po yung nangyayari sa Book of Acts. The favor of the people, they believe when they get together and study the Word of God. Nawa, ito po ang mga nangyayari sa ating mga cell group, sa ating mga Bible study group, sa ating mga discipleship group, or sa ating personal na buhay, sa ating mga quiet time. Diyan po nagsisimula yan, mga kapatid. Maraming mga tao sa paligid natin nangangailangan ng salita ng Diyos. At kapag nakita nila ang ating pananampalataya at ang ating eagerness in studying the Word of God, then sila rin po ay mahikayat natin. Amen? You know, I remember when I was in college, I have this classmate of mine, you know, who brings his Bible in his backpack, you know. And from time to time, nakikita ko siya nagbabasa ng Bible na mag-isa. And sometimes nakikita ko dalawa sila or tatlo at na-attract po ako sa ginagawa nila. Ako po ay baby Christian pa noon at that time. And because, you know, of my curiosity, I joined that small group of 3 people studying the Word of God. At kami po ay nag-aaral ng salita ng Word ng Diyos sa campus kung saan ako nag-aaral, at hanggang kami ay dumami. At malaala ko, bago ko mag-graduate, you know, there were about close to 20 of us in that Bible study. Paano po nagsimula? Dahil sa isang taong nagpagkita ng eagerness in studying the Word of God. As a true disciple of Jesus today, receive the Word of God with eagerness. Whether you are alone in your quiet time, be consistent student of the Word. Wherever you are, in your school, in your office, in your during your break time, find time to study and read the Word of God. That will strengthen your faith. Huwag mong ikahiya na ikaw ay Christian. Okay? And as a believer of God's Word, you need to share the Word of God. Marami pong paraan na pag-share ng Word of God. You can share it, you know, verbally, by declaring it, by sharing it to your friends, to your family members, to your classmates. Today, you can share it through your cell phone, through social media. You know, so social media, each time you share a verse, you know, or a gospel message, it is a powerful seed of the Word of God. That is the seed that you are already planting in the hearts of the people na nakakabasa nito, you know? And leave the result and conviction to the Holy Spirit. Mga kapatid, gamitin po natin yung ating mga Facebook, Messenger, Twitter, or whatever that is, Instagram, Viber, okay, to share God's Word. Hindi mo man magawa in every day, but at least, pag merong Word of God na nangusap sa iyo and it is worth sharing, share it to your friends. To share it, you know, to your Facebook friends. That is the seed of the Word of God. So let's make the most of every opportunity to read, to meditate, and share the Word of God with eagerness. With eagerness. Do not neglect the power of the Word of God. Remember, it's the only thing that will remain forever. Anong sabi sa Matthew 24:35? Jesus said, "Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away. All will remain forever." You know, if you wanted to be molded and be transformed as a disciple of Jesus Christ, you study the Word of God. Because it's the only thing that can transform you and that can mold you to be the kind of person God wants you to be. Number 4, our attitude is to receive the Word of God with a humble heart. To receive the Word of God with humility. Sabi sa James 1:21, "Therefore, get rid of all moral filth and the evil that is so prevalent, and humbly accept the word that is planted in you, which can save you. Amen. The only thing that can save us is the word of God. The only thing that can save us from hell is the power of the word of God, the gospel. The only thing that can save us from our problems, from temptations, from anything, our trials, is the word of God. Amen, church. So let me ask you, what is your attitude towards the word of God? Okay, or when a message like this is shared, are you taking it lightly or are you taking it very seriously? Do you accept it with a humble heart? Do you put yourself under the word of God? Do you subject your situation under the word of God? Or do you say, Lord, because you said it, I believe it, and that settles it. I'll obey you. Or you say, Lord, this situation of mine, this temptation of mine, I put it under your word. By your grace, help me, Lord. Or you are saying, Lord, you said in your word, do not worry. So, Lord, I will not worry. Amen. I trust you. Or you say, Lord, this unbelief, this bad habit, this bad attitude of mine, I subject it to your word. Help me, Lord. Transform me. Make me victorious over the situation. For the word of God says in Hebrews chapter 4 verse 12, for the word of God is alive and active, sharper than any double-edged sword. It penetrates even to the dividing soul and spirit, joints and marrow. It judges the thoughts and attitude of the heart. And in verse 13 says, nothing in all creation is hidden from God's sight. Everything is uncovered and laid before the eyes of Him to whom we must give account. You know, church, the Word of God is not simply a collection of words from God. It is not just a story to listen or to tell to others, but it is living, life-changing, and dynamic as it works in us. Yes, it is life-changing. Itong Word of God ay nakapagbabago sa ating buhay. That's why, you know, I said, this is about molding our character, and we need the Word of God. God's Word reveals who we are and who we are not. It penetrates the core of our moral and spiritual life. It discerns what within us, both good and evil. Wala tayong maitatago sa Diyos, ito'y nahayag sa kanyang salita. Again, let us not only listen to the word, let us also be shaped and be molded by the word of God. That is if we humble ourselves before God and before His word. You know, if it rebukes you, corrects you, disciplines you, and trains you into righteousness, accept it with humility. Anong sabi sa 2 Timothy 3:16 to 17? All scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness. And verse 17, so that the servant of God, okay, a disciple of God, may be thoroughly equipped for every good work. Kaya, hayaan natin yung Word of God to rebuke us, to correct us, to train us, you know, and to righteousness. Kailangan po natin yun. Ano po? So, anuman ang need mo ngayon, anuman ang mga pagsubok na hinaharap mo ngayon, temptation na meron ka man ngayon, mga young people out there, whatever, you know, the enemy is doing in your life right now, you can be victorious. You take the Word of God. Study the Word of God. Ang salita ng Diyos ang kailangan natin. Ang salita ng Diyos ang magbibigay sa atin ng lakas. Magbabad tayo sa salita ng Diyos. Tanggapin ang kanyang salita ng nagpapakumbaba. At sinasabi, Lord, thank you for touching my heart through your word. Sabi sa James chapter 4, verse 6 to 7, God opposes the proud but gives grace to the humble. Submit yourselves then to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Alam nyo, pag-pride po ang pinairal natin lagi. Di po tayo lalago at di po tayo makamove on. You know, sana ang attitude natin ay hindi yung alam ko na yan, memorize ko na yan. Sana hindi yung attitude natin ay yung alam ko na yung bagay na yan. Mas magaling ako dyan. Sino ba ang speaker? Sino ba ang tagapagsalita? Sino ba yan? You know? Kaya dapat po maging thankful tayo. You know, magiging humble tayo. When God is speaking to us, whether that person, you know, is uneducated or unschooled, whoever, sino man ang ginagamit ng Diyos, mga kapatid, pasalamatan natin ang Diyos sa kanyang salita. Receive God's word with a humble and gentle spirit. Say thank you, Lord, sa word mo. Say thank you, Lord, sa correction mo. Lord, thank you sa messenger mo kahit sino pa siya. Lord, for as long as your word is preached, I receive your word with eagerness and with humility. Amen, church. Number 5, attitude is to agree with God and His word. Meaning, trust God. Don't doubt. Okay? Believe God's word. Jesus said in Matthew chapter 28 verse 20, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. Mga kapatid, don't let your heart be like the thorny ground in the parable of the sower. In Mark chapter 4 verse 18 to 19, sabi doon, says, still others like seed sown on among thorns, hear the word, but the worries of life, the deceitfulness of wealth, and the desires for other things come in and choke the word, making it unfruitful. Mga kapatid, what makes the heart a thorny ground? Paano po ito naging thorny ground? The Bible says, when worries of life, deceitfulness of wealth, at kung ang mga alalahanin sa mundo at ang pagnanais ng mga makamundong bagay, kung ito ang nagahari sa ating mga puso, ay natuchok daw at hindi lumalago ang salita ng Word of God. Nakakalimutan mo ang salita ng Diyos. Nawawala yung believing mo sa Word. Nawawala yung mga messages ni Lord sa iyo. It seems that your trust in God and His Word is fading and losing your grip in the Word of God. So your tendency now is to dwell in your worries and you dwell in worldly ways. Wala na kasing Word. However, you know, when you have the Word of God, when you keep it in your heart, you mean you stand on the Word of God and believe the Word of God, that is your weapon for victory. How do we agree with the Word of God? Well, church, check your heart. Do you truly trust God and His Word? In whatever situation you're in right now, don't let Satan snatch away the Word of God in your heart. Amen? Whatever your problem that you're facing right now, God has an answer from His Word. Okay? Whatever is tempting you now, one, find strength in His promised word. Do you find strength in God's word? Take God's word, stand firm in His word, and no matter what, embrace the Word of God. Keep believing. Keep declaring the Word of God. Okay? Number two, how do we agree with the Word of God? In your prayers, agree with God and declare the Word of God. Use the scripture verses in your prayer. Yung bang sinasabi, Lord, you said in your word that by your wounds I am healed. Then, Lord, I declare that I am healed of my sickness and diseases. Lord, you said in your word that you will supply all my needs. Lord, I have a need and I am believing that you will supply all my needs. You know what, church? Use the scripture. Ang tawag doon, petition. Okay? You are taking God at His word. You are believing it. You're declaring it by faith. Number three, to agree means, you know, in doing warfare, take the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. Sabi sa Ephesians chapter 6, verse 17, the Word of God is our weapon, our sword against the enemy. Remember Jesus Christ when He was tempted by Satan, by the enemy, He used the scripture, okay, to defeat the enemy. Sabi niya palagi, the scripture says, the scripture says, the scripture says. Pwede din natin gawin yon, mga kapatid. Kaya kailangan alam natin ang Word of God. Alam natin yung ating sword of the Spirit. Dapat alam natin yung ating mga offensive weapon. Okay? The sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. And to agree with the Word of God, just do what the Word of God says. Amen? Take a step of faith. When God says go, then go. When God says give, then give. Okay? When God says wait, then wait. When God says come, come to Him. Amen, church? Sabi nga sa James chapter 1, verse 22, do not merely listen to the word and so deceive yourselves, but do what it says. And verse 25 of the same chapter says, if you do or if you obey, you will be blessed in what you do. Yes, church, take a step of faith. Do what the Lord says. Our job is to take a step of faith. It is God's job to perform His word. Amen, church? Again, to agree with God's word, okay, is to say amen. Okay, church? When every time we say amen, this is a solemn ratification or approval. Parang sinasabi mo, okay, every time you say amen, so be it. I agree. I believe. Kaya every time you say amen, you are entering into an agreement with God. You are believing God. Lord, yes ako dyan. Amen po ako dyan. Amen, church? So, you are entering into a solemn agreement with God through His word or through His message. So like right now, as I preach the word of God, every time there is a word that speaks to your heart, you say, amen, Lord. I believe you. I take your word. In your heart, you are agreeing with God, and I'll assure you, God will never fail you. So keep declaring amen. Like every time you hear the word of God, you agree. Let faith arise in you. Amen? Get excited about God's promises. Keep declaring amen. Let the enemy hear you say amen. Because, you know what, church? The enemy cannot read your minds. But he can hear you declaring amen to the word of God. When you say amen, you are not just agreeing with God, okay, but you are also reminding yourself. Amen, church? Kaya parang sinasabihan mo ang salita ng Diyos ay para sa'yo, tinatanggap ko. So again, this amen is a solemn ratification or solemn approval of what God says to you and through you. Amen, church? Amen? Amen. Okay? Use your mouth, your tongue, to say amen to God's word. Church, Jesus said, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. So I said the third M in discipleship is molding, meaning to mold or transform the lives of the believers or disciples. We need to obey God and we must obey the Word of God and allow God to mold us to be the kind of person God wants us to be. To let God use His Word to usher us to our God-given assignment, to usher us to do the will of God in our lives. As a disciple of Jesus and in making disciples of Jesus, our attitude towards the Word matters. Amen, church? Number one, we need to hear and accept God's Word in our heart. Make our heart a good and fertile ground of the Word of God. Number two, to receive it as Word of God, not as Word of men. Whoever is preaching the Word of God, that is not his Word, but that is the Word of God. Number three, receive the Word of God with great eagerness, meaning with enthusiastic desire and excitement. Every day, like the Bereans, search and meditate the Word of God. Number four, receive the Word of God with a humble heart. Why? Because God opposes the proud but gives grace to the humble. Put yourself under the Word of God. Put your situation, your challenges under the Word of God. Receive it with a thankful heart. Respond positively according to the Word. And number five, always agree with God and His Word. Amen, church. Let us pray right now. Let's bow our head. Listen, church, as a true disciple, how is your attitude towards the Word of God? How do you value the Word of God? How do you pay attention to God's Word every day? Honestly, kumusta po ang ating quiet time? Ang ating devotional time, do you take time, whether that is 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 30 minutes, the most important thing is naisip mo ang Diyos, napasalamatan mo ang Panginoon, nag-meditate ka ng Word of God niya. So honestly, how's your quiet time? How's your devotional time? How's your attitude in listening to God's messages? Are you excited? Are you taking it very seriously as if God is speaking to you right now? Alam niyo mga kapatid, it's only about our character. Check your attitude, your character towards the Word of God. Pasalamatan mo ang Panginoon. Hold on to the Word of God. You know what? Our strength, our faith, good success, our growth, fruitfulness, our prosperity, God's plan begins with the Word of God. Hallelujah. Take the Word of God. Be molded by the Word of God. Let us pray. Thank you, Lord, for your Word. Thank you that your Word has entrance in my heart. Lord, I come back to your Word. I give it first place in my life. Help me to prioritize your Word. Help me to grow in my faith through your Word. For your Word says faith comes by hearing and hearing the Word of God. Lord, help me to spend time in hearing, reading, and meditating your Word so my faith will become strong. Lord, as a Christian believer, as your follower, forgive me that sometimes I neglect your Word. Forgive me that sometimes I am busy with other things, that I'm not consistent in my devotional, that I'm not consistent in believing and taking your Word very seriously. Lord, today by your grace, I commit my life to your word. I commit to be a good student of your word. I will listen to it regularly. I will read it and meditate on it every day and every night. Lord, by your grace, help me to be a good student of your word. Help me to obey your word with a humble heart. Lord God, just like your instruction to Joshua, Lord, help me to read and meditate your word day and night so I will experience good success. Lord, you said in Psalm chapter 1 that as we delight in your word, as we meditate day and night, I will be like a tree planted by streams of water which yields its fruit in season and whose leaf does not wither. Whatever he does prospers. Lord, thank you that through your word, you are molding me to be the kind of person you want me to be. Lord, through your word, you are leading me to victory and good success. Lord, thank you that we are free to meditate and study your word. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for the Holy Spirit who is our teacher in studying the word of God. Thank you, Lord. Let the power of God be upon me through his word. Thank you, Jesus, for you are the living word. I pray this with thanksgiving in Jesus' name. And now may the love of God, the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the empowerment and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you wherever you go. Let the shalom of God be with you, the peace of God, nothing missing, nothing lacking, nothing broken. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, church. The Lord bless you.